This is Hellion, the new version that came out, 0.2.8, I believe. So let's pick us a server and see where this goes. Looks like we got 11 people on board. Begin our journey. Press. Okay. So we'll see where this takes us this time. I'm sure everything's similar to what we had before. There's outer space. Put our pressure suit on. It gives us our pockets. Let's pick up the stim pack. Pick up the welding tool. Wonder if there's anything in here. Nothing. Okay. Don't have electricity. Pick up the extinguisher and see what parts are in the box. And we have nothing. Okay, interesting. Nothing in there, but we do have a warp cell. And I just saw sparks. Oh, we're in the debris field. Awesome. Okay, we're in a shrapnel field. Grab the battery. Let's get our jetpack on, our helmet. And there's our display on the bottom left. Oxygen near full. Exterior pressure at normal normal pressures. We do have a debris field, as shown with the red mark. Jetpack. Looks like the fuel on the right side is, I don't know, about 80% full. But right now we don't need to worry about that. Let's get out of here. I'm gonna assume this is very similar to the last version, so. If I'm wrong, I guess we'll just play along. We'll dump the CQM, and it didn't dump. What's going on with that? Pull that down. The door. Pull that. There we go. CQM's disconnected. We don't need that. Oh, labels. We got the main room. Okay. Put on some gravity. Turn the gravity on. There we go. And let's assign ourselves a bed in case something happens. Confirm, there's our new cryo bed. We got suits. Let's get our solar panels extracted and power up the base. Solar panels are above us, as I stated in a previous video. There we go, we have power. And the capacitor is charging. We are producing this, and the base uses this, so we have an excess that is shown here. If we had the CQM the one that we just dumped, if we kept that connected, then this number would have been lower. We wouldn't be generating as much electricity. More would be required for a bigger base. So at this point, we need to just kind of get out of Dodge, get out of this orbit. So let's depressurize the station. And okay, it looks like everything's working. Let's check the boxes while we're waiting. Can even pick these up while we're waiting. Gonna dump them. Attach point. This is everything that's in that canister. We're just going to unload it into the base. This is a storage area for the base. Now if I pick that canister up and look, you'll see there's nothing left. Nothing left in there. So I'm just going to throw that there for now. We're going to do the same with this. Attach point. This is everything in that canister. Put it in storage. Take it out of there. And actually, you know what? We'll just dump that one too. Base is losing pressure, so we gotta keep that in mind. Where is it at? It's at 0.5, so it's halfway decompressed. So we better put down our helmet. Once the lights turn red, then you know it's unbreathable atmosphere. Regardless, I attach, there we go, it's red. I attach the welding tool to the cargo terminal. Attach point, here's our welding tool. It only has 10 units of 8 out of 80. So we're gonna fill it up so we can do some repairs if it's necessary. Okay, well, we only have 47, so that's fine. Let's see what we have. Okay, we have... you can hear the air is slowly losing, or sound is losing its ability to travel through the station, because we don't have air in here anymore. Life support, where are we at? 0.1. Okay, we're almost in a perfect vacuum now. And... alright. Nice. Let's go outside. Make sure we're not in a debris field. And we are not. Big planet of Bether. Let's run over to our interlock module here. I'm not gonna bring this with us. I don't think we're gonna need it. We do have two helmets, we could take these with us. We got some air canisters, we could use those. Battery, we'll take that. And, oh, here we go. Core containment field generator, we're definitely gonna need that. So we'll take that. And let's head out this door. Looks like we got a derelict here. We're gonna float to this derelict. have to remember there are others out there. Keep that in mind as you are floating about. The longer you are here, the sooner you will be recognized or found. Take another air canister. Oh, it looks like we have bullets or a magazine. Let's see, what else do we find here? Oh, here we go. What do we got? This is a resource injector. Okay. And container. Good. Is that it? I'll bet you that's it. Oh, there's the moon. Burner. Back to the base, put our stuff in there. Kind of be mindful of oxygen consumption on our left. We don't want to. Actually, let's go to the ship because I think it has more storage area than the base here. Where is our ship? And there she is. Make this one kind of quick here. Get inside. Atmosphere. So I'm gonna have to get this to float here. Tap G, let it go. Let's depressurize. Wrong button there. Don't want to do that. Shut our light off. That's what I meant to do. Okay, let's open the door. Oh, nice. Grab the helmet. Get inside. We can even throw this in here. And get to the panel. Close the outer door, and then pressurize. Okay, where's that helmet? There it is. Clunky old equipment. Gotta love it. Okay, we have gravity. Let's lock the door and put our stuff away. Oh, okay, this is the engine room. Excellent. And there's a core containment field generator. You know what? Let's put the other one in while we're at it. And, okay, that we can use in the station. This we can put in storage. We already have one there. Just put that there. again, so bear with me as I learn all the ins and outs of the ship. Now it seems like oh, that's the servo would go there. So I don't see a place. Oh, this doesn't have an oxygen generator, only an air filter. Okay. Pull that up, put this back in storage. Good deal. Looks like we ran out of power. Why? Oh, we're probably on the dark side of the planet. We are orbiting, so let's go authorize ourselves. Get authority to do things. We are claiming it. Change the ship name. We're gonna call this Athena. Okay, and we'll change the ship emblem. That one. And there it is. Pretty cool. And we're not on the dark side, so we probably have to extend the solar panels. Power supply. Okay, deploying the solar panels. There we go. Now we are generating power, which is always a good thing. And let's see how we're doing on oxygen, clean air. If we power it up, could see how much it uses. Right now we're using let's see, that doesn't really show total usage, does it? Probably not here. Okay, we are producing nearly 600 units of power, but we are using a total of 325. We can always, so we have an excess of 271. We can always help by shutting off the air filter. Now we can charge up our capacitor a little quicker, but the air will get deadly from carbon dioxide that we breathe out, so we gotta be mindful of that. Alright, let's jump away here. Let's take a... oops. Everything here. Oh, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So 1, 2 is the map. There's the map, okay. And that's us right there in relation to Bether, the planet. We are approaching the dark side. Let's do a scan. See if anybody's in the area. We have a few people. Outpost, Steropes. I don't know if it's pronounced Steropes, Steropes. I don't know. I'll have to look it up. But it does look like we have somebody nearby. Well, let's, Athena. Okay, that's us right there. Yep. We need to get out of here, though. In our current orbit, it would take us 44 minutes to make one full orbit around the planet. We are at this position, angular, to the planet. Let's see here. Inclination, we have an 18 degree incline to horizontal. Okay, interesting. So it gives us our periapsis and apoapsis. That's good. Near perfect orbit. So what we need to do is we need to get ourselves out of here. So we're going to move forward a little. Using the docking on the docking collar on the bottom of the ship, we're going to connect to our outpost. So let's take a gander at the bottom camera. That's our anchor. On the right we have the outpost selected, and it is straight ahead. We are getting closer, so speed this up, shall we? Cool, okay. Oh, and it looks like we're in a debris field again. So let's select the docking collar. Quick, so we can jump out of here. The other items, the CQM that I ejected from the base, we won't need. And the airlock for the time being, we won't need either. Let's see here. How does this read? So we want to turn to the left. And there is no atmosphere in space, so this is about as real as it gets when it comes to space simulators. There we go, perfect. Nice alignment. Gotta come in slow. Oh, must have got bumped. Come in slow, less than 0.1 meter a second. So that we wouldn't run into anything. I mean, look at all this metal just flying everywhere. So we need to get out of here. Let's take a look at those just for a visual reference and see what we're doing. Pulling up and back. Good. Let's see what 4 is. Looks like the keys are labeled at the top. 1 would be sitting in the ship. 2 is the map. 3 is the docking port, which is already connected. 4 is, I don't know what 4 is, so we got much to learn. To talk, but I'm recording. I will talk to him in a bit. Let's jump out of here. Whoops, wrong key. Interesting changes. I like it. Take a bit of getting used to. So, do another scan, make sure nobody's around. Somebody there. And objects authorized, okay. That's in our cluster, okay. Please select a maneuver. Well, I want a warp. Okay, no distress signals. Custom orbit. Interesting. Okay. Now, how do we do a custom orbit? Okay, that's right. Select the planet, add a custom orbit, and now we can tweak these. We're going to make this kind of big, not too big. Side. I'm going to turn left a little bit. Follow the arrows. jumping in, you'll see the center of the screen, just below the green star or square, 5 seconds to warp. Bases or other ships in the area by repeatedly scanning. By having this kind of an angular, if you see it's on an angular or an angle, the orbit, I always have sunlight at all times. Well, 99% of the time. So, it allows me to have power and I don't have to worry about sunlight. So, we've almost arrived at our destination. 5 seconds. And that's a beautiful thing. Let's see how much warp we used. This was at 100%, so if we take a look at it, 86% now, so that's not too bad. Alright, well, let's go back out to the station, shut the inner door, depressurize. Down before we die. Let's make sure we have everything on us. We do. And open the outer door. Oh, that's so beautiful. And there you could see how it docks to the locking collar, which is a good thing. And over here, we have a little bit of a hole in the station. We had to repair that. listener. And let's go pressurize. The base so we can breathe once again. Corridor B is right there. Corridor A is over there. And the main room, well, we're standing in it. Main room, corridor B, corridor A. And Athena has the airlock, storage, bridge, engineering. Okay, cool. Very, very good. Air generator now. Let's see what parts we have. We're gonna stick this thing right in here. Everything once again. Let's get these canisters stored away in the ship. There's nowhere to put them in here. And I should have done that in the first place, but I had that helmet in my hand. I didn't have any room. Excuses, excuses. Wait till it's completely empty because we don't want to lose anything at this point, just starting out. And everything in the game has to be treated as a valuable commodity and something that has to be taken care of to survival game. So let's throw that in there. Pressurize, and there we go. Grenades. weaponry. Actually, right now, see, I could take these and fit them there, but right now I'm gonna hold off. I might find a gun. I might need that. Batteries, however. See a storage location, so we'll just put them up here. Stim packs, I'm gonna keep one on me. Air canisters, or container, whatever you want to call it. Them up there. And I think that's about it. Alright, let's go back to the base. What do we have here? Okay, more storage. And then we got the drill. Sound stopped working there. A little bit of a bug. All right, outer door. Starting to run low on oxygen, so it's all good. Good. Let's take our jetpack off and fill that up. Attach point, drag some oxygen, fill it up. Nitrogen for steering and propulsion. And how's the battery? Battery looks about 90% full, so we will charge it. Charging station, and we might as well fill these things up too. Oxygen, nitrogen, that one's completely full. Oxygen, nitrogen, and now we can take all these back over here. Those are completely filled, ready to be used. Got another stim pack, nothing in the drawers. Very, very good. Okay, I think that's it. We're gonna call it for now. We have got a secure orbit. And a place to sleep. Always make sure your helmet is off or your visor is up, or you will consume the resources in your jetpack, and you don't want to do that because the next time you log in, you will be dead. So I will leave you with that, and this is the beginning of Hellion 0.2.8, and part one is over, and we'll talk to you later. See ya.